Okay, so this video is going to cover how to solve a system using the elimination method, focusing on the special cases. So if you haven't quite exactly got the method of elimination method down, I would recommend to watch my video over just solving a system using the elimination method before moving on to this video, which focuses on the special cases. So then what we know about solving a system using the elimination method is that our goal is to add our system together in the hopes of either getting our x values or our y values to cancel out. Now, in order for that to happen, what we need is we need to look at the coefficients of our x or y values. So either choose to cancel out the x or choose to cancel out the y. I'm going to choose to cancel out the x. So that means in order for my x values to cancel out my coefficients, what I'm looking for is for them to be opposites of each other, which means they need to have the same number but different signs. So then the first thing I need to look at is, well, here I have a 6 and a negative 18. And the first multiple that 6 and an 18 has in common is an 18. So then, since the bottom equation already has an 18, I don't need to mess with that one. I can go straight to the top equation and tweak that one. So remember, we can't just multiply the 6 by something to make it 18. We have to multiply the entire equation by that same number. So then looking at 6, we know that 6 times 3 would give us 18. So what we're going to do is multiply that top equation by 3. So that it can turn that into an 18. So we're going to distribute that 3 across the entire equation. So 3 times 6x gives us 18x minus 3 times 6x is 18x minus 3 times 3y, which is 9y, and that's equal to 3 times 4, which is 12. Now that bottom equation, I'm just going to scooch over. We did not do anything to it, but I'm going to move it over so that I can now add my two equations together in the hopes of something canceling out. So proceeding with that, so here we have 18 plus a negative 18, which does cancel out. Then we have negative 9 plus a positive 9, which that also cancels out as well. So that means everything on the left-hand side canceled out, which means we have nothing left, which means we have a 0. On the right hand side, we have 12 plus a negative 16, which is a negative 4. So then take a look at our answer here. 0 equals negative 4. Now, 0 does not equal negative 4. There's no possible way that those are equal to each other. So this is what a no solution would look like. You get an answer that does not make sense. It just means this is unsolvable. There is no solution to it. These lines are just never going to intersect. They're never going to have any points in common, which is what this means. Okay, so here we just have another example. So we're still solving the system using the elimination method. So that means that we need to look over this problem and just see if anything happens to cancel out from the beginning. So if we were going to add our x values together, 5 plus 25 would give us a 30. And our y values over here, 6 plus 30 would give us a 36y. So nothing would cancel out there from the beginning, which means this one will need to be tweaked. So then again, I'm going to cancel out the x values. And the first thing that a 5 and a 25 has in common is 25. So once again, this one here, it looks like that bottom equation is good. That one will not have to be tweaked. So I'm just going to move that one over, which means this top equation, since 25 is the first multiple I have in common here, I need to turn that 5 into a 25, which means I'm going to multiply it by a 5. Remember that 5 is going to have to be multiplied to the entire equation, not just the first term. Also remember that in order for those x terms to cancel out, we don't simply just need them to be the same number. We need them to be opposites, which means one has to be positive, one has to be negative. Since the bottom equation already has a positive 25, let's go ahead and make our top equation to be negative 25. So that just means since we need it to be negative, we just need to tack on to this negative, tack on that negative to that 5 that we're already going to be multiplying the equation by. Okay, so multiplying that out, we have negative 5 times 5x, which gives us negative 25x. Negative 5 times 6y gives us a negative 30y. And negative 5 times 15 gives us a negative 75. Now that we have that in the proper form, we can now add our two equations together and see what we get. So starting with adding our x terms, we have negative 25 plus 25, which cancels. Then we have negative 30y plus 30y, which also cancels. So notice on the left-hand side, we're once again left with 0. We don't have anything left, so that's understood to be 0. On the right-hand side, though, we have negative 25 plus 75, which also cancels out, which means on the right-hand side, we also get a 0. So then let's take a look at this. 0 equals 0. Well, does 0 equal 0? Of course it does. So we get a true answer. It does make sense. 0 does equal 0. So this is what we call an infinitely many solutions. So this is what we call infinitely many solutions. If you notice our equations, if we were just to simplify this bottom equation here, if we divided each one of those terms by 5, we would get the top equation. They are the exact same equations, just in different forms, which means since they are the same line, they do share every single point together. Let's talk about another way to write infinitely many solutions. So a lot of times you can simply just state infinitely many solutions. Other times we may see this notation that looks like this. This notation says that our solution is every point x, y, such that it is in this equation. So essentially all that really means is that our answer to this system is every coordinate x and y that pertains to our equation, that pertains to our line. So if it's on our line, it is a solution.